Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today we're here with another review. We're gonna have a closer look to these two Bullyland figures. The first one is the Knight Nerubim in a gift box, and the next one is the horse of this dark warrior, which is actually a female and her name is Nightmare. So, and if we take a look back here, we can have these nice informations. I don't know what this is about, if this, probably you cut this. I don't know if this supposed to be, you know, some sort of a game, Bullyland Hunt, because only these two figures of them have these cards behind them. The other, you know, knights, a few knights that Bullyland has, don't have these cards, you know, to cut on from their boxes behind. So anyway, let's have a closer look and see what and read what it says. Here, she does not look it, but the Nightmare is thoroughly vicious. Only a few fighters master the core and the strength to ride. So that is interesting. Probably it's that's why you see it is a Nightmare horse. That's why they call it Nightmare. Of course, it's this, you know, it's his horse, the Dark Knight. The Knight Nerubim. Just like the Nightmare horse, Nerubim has also a few cool info of him on the back side of his box as well. It says that his face disfigured by immemorable battles is concealed by a vile mask. He prefers swinging the mace as a second weapon rather than using a protective shield. His goal is to extinguish all that is good, all that is light, and to let the evil reign forever. So he's a pretty bad guy, someone could say. So, to be honest, when I saw them on their side, they look more purple, to be honest, and I was surprised by when I got them. And what I mean by that, I mean they looked something like that. So, you can see that these two are a little bit different as far as the color. And of course, you can see the Bullyland symbol on both of their boxes. From this side, there's nothing, you know, special. They're just symbol boxes. And this is how they look from the underneath part of them. Anyway, so let's waste no time and open this up. So here we are. These figures look very nice, you know, very appealing on the eye. I will put also their Bullyland codes for them on the description down below. And also a link that you can also find them too, in case you are interested. So, without further ado, let's have first a closer look on them, and then we can compare with some other figures. So, let's start with Nerubim, which is actually, I think, the star of this video. So, and as I can say, he looks very amazing, you know, very, you know, dark guy, you know, from the other world. It reminds me kind of some Papu figure, which I'm gonna show you later on this video. And he has also this nice symbol on his cape, some sort of he has the symbol of a sword, but it was actually made of a woman with wings, you know, like a dark angel, something like that. As you can see, this is her face, you know, like a skull. He holds this weird sword thing. She wears this outfit, and here are her wings. That's an interesting symbol. I haven't seen anything like that. But from far away, it looks, you know, kind of a sword with this holding it from this position. So that's nice. He has this kind of blonde hair. But you know, like I said, like you saw previously, he looks different from the picture that they have on their side. But yeah, he has this nice mullet on his hat instead of a shield like we read, and he wears a mask because his face is so scarred from the battles. I also love the sword of his, which actually I don't think you can remove it. This is one with his hand, as you can see. It's not a separate piece. The same with and this mullet too. It's just one piece, all of them, with his hand. Which I think it's better like this, so you don't have to afraid not to lose it. I would prefer if we could have more figures like them, so that the weapons were one with their hands, so it would make them more, you know, safe, not to lose them. I don't know what you guys think. And here you can see the Bully logo. Also nice gray outfit, you know, very too many armor on him with his shield. He has also this weird thing on his chest as well. All of these nice accessories, you know, that he has for protection on him looks, you know, more like a metallic dark warrior. Very nice with his strange looking sword. He can stand very well on his own, as you can see. He doesn't have problems by falling down. And with this movement that they have made on the cape, he looks, you know, like in a fighting position, you know. You can have a very nice diorama, place it on some, you know, cool pose on the shelf, if you have. But also, basically, he stood most on the horse, that's why we got the horse. Now, let's have a closer look on this one. Let's focus the camera. So, there it is. You can see it's very nicely sculpted right here with this silver-gold combination, which I really appreciate. It reminds me, you know, this combination of the Slay Knights and Griffins, that they have a similar combination, which I really like a lot. And you can see right here it has also a symbol of, what is this, a lion, a monkey? Don't know what exactly this one is. He has these ears, probably like a monkey, but why he has all these feathers? Something like a monkey, I would say, or some face of a king, or just a random, you know, symbol, probably. And the mask make the horse look more like a dragon. It's pretty similar to this one, Papa figure, from Papa Fantasy line, which actually this is a horse that has this cape that makes, you know, the body look like a horse, but, you know, from the head and after it is a dragon. That's why he have this, it has this, you know, dragon's tail and all things. And the warrior on it looks, you know, very creepy as well. Probably makes a lot of good combo with Nerubim. So, nice idea from Bullyland making, you know, this nice symbol to, nice armor to the horse. And with this, you know, some like of nails, teeth that he has on its back. You can see this is a very nice, pretty armored horse, you know, all over it. Has a nice detail, nice coloration. Although it looks a little bit dusty, and I'm not sure why. They don't say when it is just released, this figure. It just says Bully. It doesn't say the calendar year. So, are these figures old? I don't know. I thought they were new. But what do you guys think? I don't know exactly when they released, if they are new or old figures, but, you know, they look kinda cool to me, you know. I like these undead kind of warriors, so I think he would look very nice on my collection. But the horse has an issue, as you can see. It cannot stand probably on its own, so you might have problems with it standing. Now let's put the Nerubim on it. Yeah, of course. Maybe you can do the trick with some warm and then cold water. Maybe that would fix the problem. I think that it will, but because it's Bullyland and their figures are very, you know, soft plastic, when you can see you can bend their legs very easily. Don't know if that would work, but I will try this. So, I would recommend you to hold one of these things that you, once you remove it from the box, so you can actually make him stay right here, you know, fix this on his legs so he can actually stand and not having problems falling down. If you like, is that something that I have done to all my riders' figures. And here is, for example, how it compares with a knight from Slaeg, a Griffin knight from Slaeg, that we have also reviewed on the channel. So, as you can see on the scale, they look pretty same. That's very nice, you know, scale of them. And here is, let me show you some more creepy, you know, warriors. We have also this one from Pavo, Undead Horse, which looks very nice compared to him as well. And we have also these two, that they also, you know, the Ghost Rider and the Dark Knight from Papo as well. They look, you know, very from the dark, from the shadows, like, you know, they are dark warriors, which I really like them. So he scales pretty well with them. You can see they have also similar faces. He wears this kind of a mask, so you cannot see his face. Probably like it's just a shadow or something like that. The same with him. So I really like him a lot. So these are basically the one way to have him without falling down, if you make it upside down. Or if you grab him from here, he will leave, when I don't like when that happens. So the one way is these things right here, that it comes with a box. And the other one is if you have these small things. So wait and see what I'm talking about. So here it is. And as you can see, it looks very nice. It doesn't even, you can't even see it with the eye, and which I think is something really cool. You can easily remove it if you will. And you can also move him with his horse as a package, as an item, without the worries of him falling down constantly. So I would highly recommend you, if you have that things. I would like to see Bullyland making some more, you know, warriors and soldiers and knights, or Vikings and stuff like that, dwarves, generally more fantasy figures. To be honest, I'm very pleased with that figure. He has a lot of similarities with some other Papo figures. So there you have it, guys. This was the Nerubim knight and his horse, which is actually a female horse, and her name is Nightmare. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Hope you enjoyed it and I helped you out. Thanks for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it. I'm gonna see you next time. Bye.